Sairam students, welcome back. Let us continue with history lesson number 1. What, where, how and when. So let's just revise what we have learned so far in this lesson. We have learned what we can know about the past. Where we learned about the early people, that is about the food gatherers, the hunters, where they lived. We also learned how India, our country, got its name. So it is called as India and Bharat. Finding the past. How? That means how we can come to know what had happened in the past. We can come to know with the help of the manuscripts. That means they were written records. They were written by hand. They were written on the palm leaves or on the specially prepared bark of a birch tree that grew in Himalayas, and it was written in Sanskrit, Prakrit or Tamil. We can also study the records. We can find out with the help of the inscriptions. That means the writings on the hard surface, on the stone or metal. So the script that it consists, it had some letters or signs, and the kings, they wanted their records of the battles to be written on them. Archaeology, it is the study of the remains of past. Archaeologists, they study the things that are made and used in the past. That is, they explore and excavate. That is, they dig the surface of the earth to find tools, ornaments, pots, pans, coins, etc. And sometimes they even find the bones of animals, which help them to know what people ate. So, let us learn more today. We will learn about one past or many. And what do dates mean? One past or many. What does this mean? Did you notice the title of this book? Our Pasts. Past is written in the plural form. It is written to draw attention to the fact that the past was different for different groups of people. We can see some examples. Let us take the examples of the lives of herders or the farmers that were different from those of the kings and queens. The lives of merchants were different from those of the craftsperson. Now, this is true even today. People followed different practices and customs in different parts of the country. It is not same everywhere, isn't it? So, we can take some more examples. Today, most people living in the Andaman Islands, they get their own food by fishing, hunting and collecting forest produce. In contrast, most people living in cities depend on others for supplies of food. So, differences such as these existed in the past as well. There is another kind of difference. We know a great deal about the kings and the battles they fought because they kept records of their victories. But ordinary people such as the hunters, the fishing folk, the gatherers, farmers or herders, they did not keep any records of what they did. That is, the history of the ordinary people is difficult to obtain, but the kings, they had their records written, isn't it? So, archaeology helps us to find out about their lives, but there is much that remains unknown. Now, look at these pictures. Here, you can see the king, the queen in a palace. You can see a battle of the kings. In this picture, you can see the farmer plowing the field, and he is working very hard to earn his livelihood. In this image, you can see herder looking after the herd of sheep, and a craftsperson who is doing artistic work. So, what did you understand by these pictures? You understood that the life of the people is not the same. It is different for all the different groups of people. The kings, they live in the palaces, while the farmers, they live in the huts. The kings, they fight battles to secure the lives of their subjects, while the farmers, they produce food for their kings and the others. The kings, they wear rich clothes, while the farmers, they wear simple clothes. So, why do you feel the ordinary men and women did not keep a record of what they did? They might have done this because they were unaware of the art of writing. And also, they did not consider their simple lives of any importance that had to be recorded. What do dates mean? If someone is asking you for the date, then what will you say? Probably the day, the month and the year, isn't it? Now let us take one example. 2019. So it means 2019 years after birth of Jesus. Why is it so? Because birth of Jesus is supposed to be the zero point of history. So when Jesus Christ was born, that is termed as the zero point of history. And before that time, all the dates are counted backward and they are called as BC, or we will call it as before Christ. Similarly, the time after the birth of Jesus is called AD or Anno Domini. So 2019, it can be written as AD 2019. We can also use CE, that is Common Era, used instead of AD, and BCE, that is Before Common Era, used instead of BC. Now, see this image. You know Jesus Christ, isn't it? He is the founder of Christianity. So, in history, we find dates with BC or AD. That is, BC is the short form of before Christ, and AD means Anno Domini, that is after the birth of Jesus Christ. Now, AD is usually written before the number. We can have an example over here. AD 150, which means 150 years after the birth of the Christ. And in the recent times, we usually do not put AD before the year. To enable us to understand better, we can look at this image. We can see the chronological order. So, the zero year is mentioned over here. It means the birth of Jesus Christ. And towards the left, if we see, it is BC, that is before the birth of Jesus Christ. And towards our right, that is Anno Domini, AD, that is after the birth of Jesus Christ. Now, before Christ was the prehistoric or the historic period. And AD means it is the ancient, medieval as well as the modern period. BCE can be referred nowadays as Before Common Era. And BC or BCE, it is also known as BP, that is before present. A CE means Common Era. Now, the excavations, the inscriptions, the manuscripts, they only do not describe or tell us about whatever things are found in India only. Isn't it? It can be found in any place, in any country. So let us take one example now. Elsewhere, about the Rosetta Stone. Now many inscriptions, they contain both script and language. So languages change over time. So understanding the inscriptions is not simple. The language that we speak now is very much different from the language that was spoken before. So now how to understand it? So this is done by a process known as decipherment. Now the Rosetta Stone of Egypt It had inscriptions on three different languages and scripts, that is Greek and two forms of Egyptian. Look at the image of the Rosetta Stone. Now, one of the most famous stories of decipherment, as we saw, it comes from Egypt, that is a country in North Africa, where there were kings and queens about 5,000 years ago. So this Rosetta, it is a town on the north coast of Egypt, and here an inscribed stone was found which contained inscriptions in three different languages and scripts, that is the Greek and two forms of Egyptian. Now the scholars who could read Greek figured out that the names of the kings and queens were enclosed in a little frame called a cartouche. Then they placed the Greek and the Egyptian signs side by side and identified the sounds for which the Egyptian letters stood. You can see in this image, okay, as you can see, a lion, it stood for L, and a bird for A. So once they knew what the letters stood for, they could read other inscriptions as well. Now let's recap what we have learnt in this lesson so far. As we have seen, the title of the book refers to our past. So past is the plural form of the past of the different people, that is of the different groups of people. That means the kings, they had the life that was different from the farmers. We know na, the kings, they live in the palaces and they don't have to go out and work for anything. They just have to order. But the farmers, they have to do lot of hard work and they don't live in palaces. They live in villages. And also about the hunters and the religion. We learned about the different customs and traditions that these people followed. It is not same. It is all different. The trade, that is their craftspersons. Now today's craftspersons, we know, na, the musicians and all. So that time also, everyone, they had their own profession. We also learnt about the Andaman Islands and about the cities. That means the Andaman Islands, they did the jobs of fishing, hunting and collecting forest produce. They did not depend on others. Whereas the cities, they were dependent on the others. The kings, they used to have their own records. That means they had their records about the victories and battles to be mentioned. Whereas the ordinary people, they did not record anything. So it was very difficult for the archaeologists to understand the past of the ordinary people. We also learnt about the chronological order of the dates. That is, the birth of Jesus is supposed to be the zero point of history. So 2016, it means 2016 years from birth of Jesus. And BC is referred to as before Christ. AD means Anno Domini, that is in the year of the Lord. That means after Jesus Christ was born. CE can be used in place of AD, that is common era. BCE also can be used in place of BC, that is before common era. We can also use BP, that is before present. We learnt about Rosetta, that is a town at the north coast of Egypt, and here Rosetta Stone was found, which contained inscriptions in three different languages and scripts, that is Greek and two Egyptians. The scholars who could read the Greek figured out that the names of the kings and the queens, they were enclosed in frame called a cartouche, and they correlated with Greek and found the sound of Egyptian languages. I hope you have understood the lesson very well. Thank you.